Hi dear students, welcome to this class. So already we have started your syllabus in the last class. So that is our first chapter, nutrition in plants. Nutrition in plants. See students, so in the last class, so we had been regarding about how this nutrition takes place in plants in a two different kinds, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. So in last class we have discussed only about autotrophic nutrition in a plants, and you know that only green plants which are capable to produce their own food by the process photosynthesis. Yes? Okay. So that kind of nutrition, auto means what? Cell. Autotroph, troph means feeding, self feeding. That means green plants can prepare their own food. Understand? They have self feeding. So that kind of nutrition we call it as a autotrophic nutrition. How they prepare their food? By the process photosynthesis. Already clearly I explained that process photosynthesis in the last class. So once again I wish to recall that. See, plants in presence of sunlight, green plants. You know the reason for the green color of the plants? Already I told it in last class. They have a pigment called chlorophyll. They have a chlorophyll pigment. Hence, the plants are green in color. That they give the green color to the plant. And this photosynthesis that takes place in a leaf part. That takes place in a leaf part of a plant. So, the green plants in presence of sunlight. Why do they need sunlight for this process? Because preparation of food is also considered as a chemical reaction. So to combine the two compounds or elements, they need an energy. Hence, the green plants, they need a sunlight or solar energy. So that this chlorophyll present in the leaves helps in the absorption of sunlight. Helps in the absorption of sunlight, and they store this chlorophyll that absorbs the sunlight and stored it in the leaf, and that utilizes when the photosynthesis, while the photosynthesis process. Yes, okay. So this chlorophyll helps in the absorption of that sunlight. Hence, this photosynthesis process takes place only in presence of sunlight. Remember, okay. So, what is photosynthesis? What is photosynthesis? See, I repeat it once again. The green plants in presence of sunlight. They form glucose and oxygen gas. This is what we call starch. So this is what we call photosynthesis reaction. The green plants in presence of sunlight by using chlorophyll, they combine. See, photo means light, synthesis means combine. They combine. What they combine? Carbon dioxide and water. Understand? The green plants in presence of sunlight by using chlorophyll, they combine carbon dioxide and water, and they finally prepare their food. So some part of this food is utilized by the plant body. Some part of that produced food is utilized by the plant body for its activity, biological activity. The remaining food, the extra food, it is stored in a plant body in the form of starch. The extra food or remaining food in the plant body stored in the form of starch. So this starch, some plants they store the starch in different parts, like in root part, in a stem part, in fruit part, in leaves part, and in a flower part. Okay, so in which part they store the food or starch, we use that part as a food. We call that part as an edible part. Clear or not? Okay. So this is what we call photosynthesis. Then question is that how they get carbon dioxide? Okay, and how they get a water? Water. How they get a water? This is a water. Understand? How they get a water? They combine carbon dioxide and water. How? So leaves have a small tiny openings on their surfaces. We call them as a stomata. Okay. So through this stomata they intake a carbon dioxide. Okay. The leaves contain small tiny pores on their surfaces. They are called as stomatas. Through this stomata they intake a carbon dioxide. Then how this water came? Already know the roots of the plants, they absorb the water from the soil and they send them to the shoot system. You know, plant basically has a two parts. So this is a root part, this is a shoot part. This is the root part, this is a shoot part. Okay. So this plant roots absorb water and sends them to the shoot system. Understand? So just imagine these are the leaf is there. Here leaf is there. So this water that sends to the leaves of a plant body through the tissue. Here the tissue is there. Which tissue? Xylem tissue is there. Understand? This shoot system that mainly contains two vascular tissues. This shoot system. Shoot is nothing but stem. This shoot system that mainly contains two vascular tissues. They act as a conducting tissues. They help in the conduction of two materials in the plant body. One is water and the other is food. Here, when the root absorbs water and this root sends the water to the shoot system. So this shoot system contains a vascular tissue or conducting tissue, that is a xylem. Through this xylem, water reaches the leaves. Understand? In this leaves, by combining carbon dioxide and water, they prepare a food or starch. Understand? After preparing food, these leaves that sends the food to the all parts of the body through the another conducting tissue. Through the another conducting tissue, that tissue is called phloem. That tissue is called phloem. So xylem tissue conducts the water, phloem tissue conducts the food. Understand? Xylem conducts water from roots to the leaves. Phloem conducts the food from leaves to the all parts of the plant body. Hence, xylem is called water conducting tissue, phloem is called food conducting tissue. Clear or not? So this is what you have learnt in a last class. Clear or not? So this is about a process, photosynthesis. So now in this class you will go to learn about the importance of this photosynthesis. What? Importance of photosynthesis. Importance of photosynthesis. See students, the importance of photosynthesis. So it has its own importance and it is a natural process. In this natural process, in this unique process, solar energy is utilized. Solar energy or sunlight is utilized to prepare the food. Understand? So as I told, after this photosynthesis, after the preparation of food, some part of the food is replaced by the plant body for its biological activity, and the remaining or extra food is stored in the form of starch in a different parts of a plant body. Understand? It's a very natural process. Understand? Because we are all depending upon directly or indirectly on the green plants for our food. If plants, green plants did not prepare this food by the process photosynthesis, how can we get a food? So it's very important. It is to be happen in a green plant. Remember, Only green plants prepare their own food by the process photosynthesis. Understand? The second importance is that, second importance, so that is, all animals depend upon plants. All animals depend upon plants for their food, directly or indirectly. Yes, sir. All plants, all animals depend upon plants directly or indirectly on the green plants for their food. And third importance is that, in this product, byproduct is formed. In this process, byproduct, which is that oxygen gas is produced. Oxygen gas is released, which is very essential for the all living beings for respiration. If a plant cannot show this photosynthesis process, then how can we get oxygen for our respiration? Hence, photosynthesis is very important in a green plants. Yes, sir. Then the last importance is there. See, we are animals, not only human beings, other animals. We show the respiration. In the time of respiration, while breathing, we are breathing out what, you know, carbon dioxide. We breathe out carbon dioxide and we intake the oxygen. Yes, sir. So plants, green plants, they utilize the carbon dioxide. They utilize the carbon dioxide, what we breathe out in the atmosphere. So that carbon dioxide is intaken by these plants. Understand? And they utilize that carbon dioxide for the process photosynthesis, and they release the oxygen gas to us. So by doing this, these green plants that maintain the level of carbon dioxide and oxygen in the atmosphere. See, it is a balanced system. They maintain a balance in the nature. They maintain the balance of your carbon dioxide and oxygen in the atmosphere. Understand? This is also very important importance of this photosynthesis. If plants cannot show this photosynthesis, so the balance is not created in the atmosphere. Understand? If we know, we say gases are balanced in the atmosphere, it is only because of this process photosynthesis. Understand? This is the last and final importance of this photosynthesis. Understand? While we breathe out carbon dioxide, it is intaken by the green plants. They combine the carbon dioxide with water and produce the food. Not only they use as food, they also release the oxygen gas during the photosynthesis. That oxygen gas is utilized by human beings as well as all animals. So hence, this oxygen and carbon dioxide levels are balanced in the atmosphere, or you can say environment. Yes, sir. Okay, student, this is the importance of this photosynthesis. So next coming concept is that heterotrophic nutrition. So now you have clearly learned about autotrophic nutrition. Let's go to the second mode of nutrition in a plant, that is heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition in plants. As I told in the last class, autotrophy, auto means self, troph means feeding, self feeding. It can be seen only in green plants. Here the second mode of nutrition in plants is there. Hetero. Understand this word, hetero. Hetero means what?
Different. Hetero means different. Troph means feeding. Troph means feeding.
Hetero means different. Troph means feeding. Heterotroph means different feeding animals. Clear? This is the word meaning. This is the word meaning. Okay. Heterotrophic nutrition. Different feeding nutrition. Clear? Okay. So let's come. So some plants, green plants, they show autotrophic nutrition. Then what about non-green plants? Then what about non-green plants? Yes, the non-green plant shows heterotrophic nutrition. That means the plants which depends upon another plants. The plants which depends upon another plants or another animal for their food. Yes sir, so that kind is called heterotrophic nutrition. Understand? So totally in this heterotrophic nutrition, four kinds are there: parasitic, saprophytic. See,
first one is there. So in heterotrophic nutrition, we see the
four kinds of plants.
First one is there, parasitic plants. Second one, saprophytic plants.
Then insectivorous plants.
The last one is there,
symbiotic. So in heterotrophic nutrition, totally we see the four kinds of plants. These are all about non-green plants. Green plants show autotrophic nutrition. But the non-green plants, they show heterotrophic nutrition. So totally in a heterotrophic nutrition, we see the four kinds of plants. First one, parasitic plants, saprophytic plants, insectivorous plants, and symbiotic plants. Clear or no? So let's go first one about parasitic plants. Okay, parasitic. See, parasite means depending upon another plant. See, here the parasitic plants is the plants which depend upon another plants for their food. They are called parasitic. The plants which depend upon which plant, so that plant we call it as a host plant. That is called host plant. Understand? So these plants, they get their nutrition from another plant. The plants which get the nutrition from another plant, so that kind of plants are called parasitic plants. Understand? From which plant they get nutrition, that plant is called host. Not only we see parasitic plants, we also see parasitic animals also. In case of animals also, we say parasitic animals. Okay, I explain with one example. See, lices are there. You know lices?
Lices are the name. Hey,
name telling you to go to hair. ಸೊ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೇನು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಣಿ, ನಾವು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಣಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಿಮ್ಮಿಂದ ಆಹಾರವನ್ನು ಪಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬದುಕ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾವೆ. ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಯಾರಿಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಫುಡ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಟು, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಸಿಸ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ಸೊ ಲೈಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಸಿ ದ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್, they get their nutrition from another plant. Understand? So from which plant they get nutrition, that plant is called a host. Best examples are there. Cuscuta. What is cuscuta? Understand? Cuscuta. And another one is the mistletoe. Cuscuta and mistletoe, these are the two examples for this parasitic plants. So pictures of these two plants are given in your textbook. Please observe that. Understand? Please observe that. They are giving you very clearly pictures. Cuscuta. See, this cuscuta plant that produces a white tubular structures which are fed on whole tree. So these tubular structures, they get their artificial food from that tree. Understand? So this is a cuscuta and mistletoe. These two are the two best examples for parasitic plants. Understand? And the one is the second kind of plants, saprophytic plants. Very easy. Saprophytic means saprophytism. Saprophyte. That means the plants which get their nutrition from
dead or decaying organic matter. Dead or decaying organic matter.
Dead or decaying organic matter. See, the plants which get nutrition from dead or decaying organic matter. Andre, koletha vastugalu illirthavalla, koletha vastugala mele belithavu sasyagalu. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು ಕೊಳೆತ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳೀತಾರೆ. ಕೊಳೆತ ಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಳೆತ ವಸ್ತುಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ, ಕೊಳೆತ ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ತಮ್ಮ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಪಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತವೆ. ಅಂತ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳಾಗಿದಾವೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು ಯಾವು ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್ ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಯಾವುದು ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್? ಮೌಲ್ಡ್
ಅಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್, ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೌಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್
ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್ ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ನೀವು. ಮಶ್ರೂಮು ನಾಯಿ ಕುಡೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ. ನಾಯಿ ಕುಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ? ಗಾರ್ಡನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೂ ಬೆಳೆದು ನೋಡಿದ್ರ ನೀವು ನಾಯಿ ಕುಡೆಯನ್ನ? ಇಲ್ಲ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಡರ್ಟಿ ಏರಿಯಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಡರ್ಟಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಕೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲೇ ತಾನೇ ಬೆಳೆದಿರ್ತವೆ ನಾಯಿ ಕುಡೆ. ನೋಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಹಳ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರ್ತಾವೆ. ದೇ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಅಂಬ್ರೆಲಾ, ಅಂಬ್ರೆಲಾ ಶೇಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾಯಿ ಕುಡೆ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ, ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದೇ ಡೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಕೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೂಲ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೇಲಿ ಬಳಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಭಾಳ ದಿವಸ ನೀವು ತಂದು ತಿನ್ನಲಾರ್ದೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೇಲೆಲ್ಲ ಬೂಶ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಹಾಂ, ಅದೇ ಇದ್ಬೋದು ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೂನ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸ್ಯಾಫೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್, ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಫೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್? ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ಸ್ಯಾಫೋಫೈಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದೇರ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಡೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಕೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್. Dead or decaying organic matter, such plants are called saprophytic plants. Best example, mushroom, bread mold and yeast. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರಿ ಗೊತ್ತು, ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೋಲ್ಡ್. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೂಸ್ಟ್ ಬೆಳೆದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್, ಅದೇ ಏನು ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಕಾಮನ್ ಆಗಿ ಮೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನು ಬೂಸ್ಟ್ ಬೂಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀರಿ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ? ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಾಪ್ರೋಪೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಟೂ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟಿವೋರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಬಯೋಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಟ್ರಾಪಿಕ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೋರ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟಿಕ್, ದೇ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಅದರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೇರ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಗೇನ್ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್. ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕಸ್ಕುಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಟೋ, ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸಾಪೋಪೇಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಗೇನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಡೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಕೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಕೊಳೆತಂಥ ವಸ್ತುಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಆಹಾರವನ್ನು ಪಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತವೆ. ಯಾವ ಮಶ್ರೂಮ್, ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಮೂಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೆಸನ್. ಇನ್ ಅ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟಿವೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಬಯೋಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ.